Hi, you know my name, and this helps. I'm an art historian, I write about art, and apart from that, I give lectures and guided tours with a focus on contemporary art. After many years working with adults, 10 years ago, I changed my focus and started working also with children. First for the age around 13 to 16. Then a bigger challenge, the age of 4. Nerve-breaking, I can tell you, to start a conversation about art with a 4-year-old. After that, nothing is difficult anymore. That is why, with some hesitation, I agreed to start teaching art history to blind people. And that is why, tonight, we put you in the dark. I want you to give the opportunity to experience art in the blind way. During my pilot lecture for the blind, I realized that they experience art the other way around. Blind people build up their imagination after research of the details by touching and by words. We, on the other hand, look at the whole picture and then focus on the details. That is, if we are interested enough. Tonight, I won't use my normal tools for a presentation. So no light, no beautiful images, no slides, no vision, just my voice to build up your imagination. All day long, we are confronted with images, and vision is not a passive translation of reality. Vision is a creative process. In our memory, we build up a system for recognition, and we all make our own interpretation of the images that enter our brain. From implicit perception, unconscious perception, your brains start processing the images. We can recognize complex figures in nanoseconds. Details of an object are enough to complete the whole image. Confronted with ambiguous figures, we are able to jump from one interpretation to the other. You all know the picture with one side, one look, the face, the other side, the face. And then back to the art. Although many artists work hard and focus on making interesting images, people look only 5 or 6 seconds average as a piece of art in the museum. Is that enough? I think not. For my experiment tonight, I will describe a piece of art before you can actually see it. Several things can happen. First, I hope you will be relieved afterwards that you can see. And your imagination can be quite different than the actual work itself. There is, of course, a huge possibility that your imagination is even better. But I hope it will enrich your experience. You can think like the artist, you can visualize the concept, and then sit back and contemplate on the work of art itself. I will describe an installation made by 2 artists from Eindhoven, Ramon Hulspas and Erik Vermeulen. In 2005, they started with a documentation project, De Wereld Vol Met Spullen, or The World Filled With Stuff. We all have a lot of stuff. Our attics and garages are loaded with it. What we do with it? We buy bigger houses and even buy more stuff. Why do we replace perfect working equipment? Can the capitalist system survive without stuff? The 2 artists don't want to give answers with their work. They want to put you in a mindset. Think and contemplate what you do with your stuff. Their installation on this subject are always different. In 2007, they completely surprised me with a beautiful, strangely beautiful and poetic big white cube in a huge factory. Stuff hang under it. It was gorgeous. Later that year, they were invited to present their work in the Van Abbe Museum. Big surprise, no white cube, no objects, but a constellation of videos with moving stuff in different phases from location to location. Interaction with stuff, interaction with the environment. Endless space, a crack in the ground, Portugal, Eindhoven. At first I was disappointed that there was no object. We all like concepts, but we prefer visual things. But then I realized that the video offered me more freedom in thinking. Now I will show you the work that is. If you haven't seen it yet, their latest presentation is part of the exhibition in the foyer next door. You can start thinking now how it will look. There is more to see. With much pleasure, I invite you to visit the exhibition in a different way now. The curator is Ben van Kollenburg. He organized works from 14 artists, and I think and I know it will give you inspiring moments, and I hope that you look more than 6 seconds. Thank you. The light can on.